Defense looked pretty good today.
Yeah, I think the ones they took 32 snaps, and you know, other than when we were down there on the 15, I mean, I think didn't give up really any explosives. You know, they had the one, they had took the penalty on the 15, backed them up, and we let a run get down there to the 2. You know, so I haven't seen that clip yet. I was about halfway through when we came over here. But I thought, all in all, I think the ones are pretty solid right now.
Yeah. I know coaches, Frank Wilson was saying a couple of days ago that they've really been getting after it in practice and looking good, the line especially.
Absolutely. And I mean, the nucleus of our group is back, you know, and then it's nice seeing Marcus Davenport take a leadership role. You know, he's always been a dynamic player, but from a leadership standpoint in the locker room and in the weight room, he's really developed his body. I mean, he's 257 pounds right now.
Has he been more vocal than he was
absolutely.
Last year?
Absolutely. Yeah. You know, and then with Josiah, I mean, last year was kind of a blur to him. He was playing a new position, you know, so he was trying to learn it, and he's a freshman.
Yeah.
You know, so from a leadership standpoint, you know, it was till later in the year to where he kind of took control of the group. And then the Kevin Strongs of the world, the Austin Jupes, the Devron Davises, all those guys are back. You know, so the big difference to me is just the vocal part of it. When somebody doesn't do it right, they're getting on to them. You know, so it's starting to be player-led, you know, which is awesome. It's a good thing to see.
Coach was talking about Kevin has had a good camp so far. Talk about it.
Yeah, he's really explosive. I think you saw that last year, but it flashed. You know, the consistency of Kevin last year was he'd make a negative yardage play and then we'd give up one. You know, but I think the consistency of him throughout spring and throughout fall camp, he's really developed. You know, Coach Davis has done a great job with him. I think he's accepted him real well. And he's by far playing his best ball right now. So, I mean, not only, and we saw him a lot in the past last year, but he's pretty, you know, pretty explosive versus the run for us right now. So we're expecting big things from him this year.
Josiah, same way?
Yep. You know, Coach Rollins done a great job developing him as well, trying to mold him into an every down backer. You know, I think last year, flashed a bunch, made a lot of big plays. We've been really working on him from the coverage aspect, you know, making sure all the checks and all those type of things that he feels good with and all that. Because, I mean, they're going to be finding him this year. You know, we try to get him one-on-one on backs a bunch last year, and he normally wins. And we'll continue to do that, but he's going to have to be able to, you know, be solid in coverage, which he will.
I asked Frank about this, but where does a guy like Josiah, is already pretty decorated for just playing 1 year, where does he go from here, the next step?
I think the biggest thing for him is like that, just being every down backer, you know. So I think developing to where he can make all the calls and checks, he can get other guys lined up. It's just not about him, you know what I'm saying? And then from a coverage aspect, we feel solid with him in coverage. And he's getting there and he's doing that, you know. And I think Josiah understands, you know, football is a what have you done for me lately business. You know, last year was last year. You had a great year. That's awesome. But that has nothing to do with 2017. You know, so it got him some confidence, but Josiah is one of those kids that's going to work extremely hard and do what he's supposed to do. So I don't think Josiah is letting last year get to him. You know, it's a clean slate, and he understands he still has to develop every day and get better, and there's a lot of things we got to continue to work on, and he's doing that.
Coach Wilson was telling us that Eric Banks moved down into that position where Solomon was previously today, and I just want to ask you how he looked down there and just kind of how you're working to fill that void.
I think, you know, we're excited about Eric Banks. You know, Eric Banks is the same thing. He came in here at 217 pounds. He's 252 right now. You know, so it's been a year. You know, so him and Davenport, you know, they're really good. Following the staff have done an unbelievable job with those guys. So, you know, playing the same position, those two ends they're pretty much symmetrical. You know, so we call one and the other, you know, a different name. But, you know, at the end of the day, they're doing the same thing. So he's a smart kid. He gets it. He understands it. He's going to be a great compliment to Davenport, you know, with the length. And he's able to rush the passer as well. So he'll be fine. He did a good job today.
Is Jared McClain still down there in that position? Is he like playing
absolutely
with Eric in that one position?
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, he took a bunch of snaps as well. He redefined his body this spring. He's a lot more chiseled, lost some of that baby fat. So he's explosive. He's had a good camp. You know, that's one thing. We're excited about our front position, kind of how we do things up front. You know, a lot of those are symmetrical. You know, so a lot of times we're going to be left and right, and you're not worried about strong and weak because those guys have gotten a little meat on them, you know, to where we're not worried about them being on a tackle. You know, so I think that'll allow us to increase our package a little bit this year to where, you know, last year we didn't have all the pieces that we wanted. You know, so hopefully we'll be a little more flexible.
You know, it was interesting. Kevin Strong visited with us the other day, and I kind of detected a little bit of a gleam in his eye when we asked him about, you know, Coach Wilson was talking about how much he had improved And we asked him about his motivation for that, and he just kind of had a little gleam in his eyes talking about, well, you know what, we didn't play all that well in the bowl game last year. Right. And so, I mean, I think he was really taking that to heart. Is that kind of behind his?
Yeah, I mean, I think our bigger thing, what we try to preach on defense is, you know, we have an and one philosophy. All we're trying to do is outplay the opposing defense. We don't care what our offense is doing, it doesn't matter. You know, so our kids just got to understand, however many negative yardage plays they have, we got to have one more. However many turnovers they got, we got to have one more. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how we get on the field. It matters how we get off the field. And I think those older guys are starting to buy into that philosophy and understand it. It ain't about them. It's about us competing the defense. If we beat the defense every time, unless Coach Brumfield screws it up on special teams, we'll win. All right? So just outplay the other guys. And I think they're starting to do that. You know, so some of those things, scrimmages like today when you're over as D are tough because there's not a defense you're competing against. You know, but I thought they did a good job. But, no, I mean, it's important to him. He's busted his ass all spring. So, I mean, he'll have a good year.
Marcus might be primed for a really big year, you think?
Oh, no doubt.
Davenport, yeah.
You know, I think the biggest thing, and you know, when we're kind of, from a coordinating standpoint, you got to realize what you got. You know, so a lot of times, you know, we had to zone pressure some on third downs a bunch last year just because I didn't feel great about us at corner. You know what I'm saying? We weren't overly talented at that position, I didn't feel like. So we had to give him a little shade and bail some things and stuff like this. But I think we really developed at the corner position, which is now going to allow us to be able to isolate Davenport a lot more. And I think we're going to try to find him week to week and how we can move him around and how we can put him on the weakest pass protector, because with him, you ain't going to have to rush five and six a bunch. I really truly believe that. Now, we'll see different protections and chipping them and things like that because they're going to worry about him. But, yeah, I expect the same thing. You know, we got to keep him healthy, and I got to do a good job of asking him what he can do well and put him in those positions.
What have you seen out of Laquelle Bass so far this fall?
Steady Eddie, man. I mean, Laquelle. You know, it's the same thing last year. Football is very important to him. He's a super smart kid. He's going to be exactly where he's supposed to be. He's going to do it how you tell him to do it. So, I mean, he's solid, man. I mean, he's a great compliment to Josiah. Because Josiah at times will take some chances. He sees some things and things like that to where Laquelle's going to be by the book. And so they're a good complement to each other in there.
How many cornerbacks do you have right now, Coach, that are ready to play game one?
You know, I think coming out of today, I think I feel good really about probably about six, to be honest with you. You know, and that's the beauty about that room now is the competition that's in it. You know, I think we added two really super talented freshmen. That are competing, you know, Tay Mosley and Sam Barnes, you know, at the cornerback position that are coming in there. They give you length, they give you twitch, athletic ability. You're coming off, you know, the two starters are back, you know, and Jupe and Devron from last year. And then we had a transfer in here, Clayton Johnson, that set out last year, kid from Oklahoma State. That's got a chance. I mean, he's playing well.
29.
Yeah. Stanley Dyes, as healthy as he's ever been since I've been here at least. And he's got all the tools you want. You know, we redshirted Carrington Kearney last year. He's a long, athletic kid. You know, that was a quarterback in high school. There's a lot of guys in that room that are 6 foot plus that can run, that have been in the system at least a year, that football's important to. So it's good, you know. Now we'll be able to use some of those guys in different packages, you know, and different down and distances to help, you know, and kind of spread it out. But there's some competition in there to where last year early there wasn't. You know, and shoot, y'all know we went through a bunch of corners, you know, and it wasn't until about game six or seven to where we felt like, all right, we got the right two out there at the same time. And so I think we'll be better at that spot this year.
How's Tedrick? Tedrick went down in that last spring game that we saw.
Right.
He's
participated every day in camp, you know. I'm being careful with him just from my standpoint, you know. I want to get him to the race, but no, he's good. And the one thing about Tedrick is, I mean, he's super solid. I mean, he's probably one of the smartest kids in the room. He's going to do exactly what you ask him to do. So he's another kid that started a bunch of ball games last year, you know, that you throw in there that you're going to see.
Where is Taylor Perry? Which safety position is he playing?
Right now he's playing Lion. He's playing the left inverted safety.
Yep. Behind CJ?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yep. So he took a bunch of snaps today, and he's going to be special. I mean, he's got something about it. He's got twitch. He's a natural ball finder. I mean, he'll play significant snaps this year.
What do you think about Josiah's got this long locks and, you know, as a defensive coach, does that matter to you at all?
No, I had long curly hair in college too.
Did you?
They wasn't that long.
Yeah.
But that's what I like about Josiah. You know, Josiah doesn't let outside things bother him. You know, I mean, he's a confident kid, and regardless how his hair looks or what he's wearing or anything like that, there's just a confidence and an aura about him to where it don't matter. He's happy. He's happy where he's at. He works his ass off. So I like that about Josiah. Now Coach Wilson might think differently, you know. I like it.
What's the most exciting thing about the defense overall? Is it the depth that you seem like you're pretty pumped about that?
Yeah, you know what? I mean, you're just excited from a coordinating standpoint. The more you got, the more guys you had played for you the previous year that are coming back, from a coordinating standpoint, the more you can do. You know, I think that was what's tough for me last year. We're a big personnel team. I like to scheme different things to get guys open and things like that from a pass rushing standpoint, to where they just don't get it, you know, initially. You can't do too much too early. And so that's what I feel like our base defense and all that, you know, 80% of our room knows. So then I feel like our sub package stuff, which only matters if you stop the run,
yeah. You
know, but I feel like our sub package stuff, it will be a much better this year, to where we got to improve on third down and turnovers. You know, we've got to create more takeaways, and we need to be better on third down. And I think that allows you to do it, you know, because I think it's one thing you go out and play low hole, high hole, I better be better than you, you know, and we always don't have those guys week in and week out. So we got to be able to scheme certain things to take guys away, and then another side still be able to cover them. You know, that was one thing in La Tech last year. You know, yeah. And the two All-Americans caught three balls.
Yeah.
Yeah, they still whooped our ass, you know, because they were better at other spots, you know. So I think this year we can neutralize some of those things and kind of help ourselves out. So that's exciting to me, you know, about the chess part of it, you know. And then I think just guys buying into your philosophy, you know, to where last year you had one set of eyes looking at a position, you know. So if somebody screwed it up, I had to see it. To where now everybody knows what they're doing, you know, our vets that are back. So now when a rookie makes a mistake, I don't even have to walk over there, because whether it's Austin Jupe or Devron Davis or Tedrick McGee or the Davenports or Kevin Strong, they got him. Hey, you got to do this, this, and this, because they know. They understand. You know, they understand the defense. They understand the expectations. So that's huge. You know, we got all those veteran eyes on it. And, you know, we had some highly touted rookies coming in. And if you don't have that nucleus, sometimes, you know, that can ruin a room. You know, whether I'm not getting enough playing time. No, coach, I'm supposed to be starting. But it's not like that. Our core is together, and they're bringing them along. So I think that's the big thing for me, that, you know, where I'm kind of really excited, is those guys have balled in and they're bringing the freshmen with them, you know, to where I think sometimes at other places, some of those juniors and seniors are worried about those guys taking their spot, you know. So instead of helping them at practice when they make a mistake, they keep their mouth shut because they're worried about, hey, if he knows as much as I know, he's better, he's more talented than me, he's going to take my spot. And it's not like that. You know, they understand all 11 collectively, you know, we're going to be as good as our weakest link. And the more they can play, the more fresh those guys stay. You know, because bottom line, they got to play a bunch of special teams. And so I think we don't have a lot of eye guys. To where I think last year, when you come into a new place, you haven't recruited everybody, and they're feeling you out as you're feeling them out, you know. So I think a lot of guys are like, man, I'm going to get mine. You know, I mean, I think that's just the natural human nature. And to where I think coach has done an unbelievable job with the team. And I think the bowl game helped, you know. But I think they realize it takes everybody. You know, and I needed my backup to be just as good as me, so I could take a break, so I could be on kickoff, I could be on punt, you know, all those type of things, to where ultimately we can reach our goal to win the West.
So Frank, Coach Wilson emphasized that. Coach, sounds like, I mean, with this freshman class, obviously got, you know, a lot of spotlight
right. In
February. Coach Wilson emphasized to his seniors, hey, you guys need to help show these guys the way. Let's get him in here and show him what to do.
I mean, you know, because he can't help it. I mean, Coach Wilson's a natural leader, you know, so he does a lot of things by example, but he does an unbelievable job with developing guys, you know, not just from a football aspect, but in their life, from a leadership role and all those things that, you know, that he's going to ask of them. He lays the plan out for them, and he teaches them and develops them to do it. So I don't think he just threw them, hey, y'all develop these guys. He taught them how to develop guys. And I think the biggest thing now is being able to have access to those guys in the summer. You know what I'm saying? Those 2 hours now a week during the summer are huge. To where it used to be, yeah, they might come to summer school, but you're touching them August 1st. You know, it's where now you got 2 hours every week all summer long. That Coach Wilson did a great job of, you know, structuring it to where, and we're meeting with those guys. You know, so it's not just veterans running rookies, the coaches are in there, you know, and now we can do football with those guys. So I think that's a big difference for incoming freshmen now. It used to be you had to graduate early to have a chance to go to string ball. Well, now you're getting installed in all summer. You're going to fall camp on day one. Everything's already been installed. You know, now you haven't ran through it with a coach, you know, but you've seen the video. You've done it. I mean, you've done all that stuff. So that's why I think you're seeing more now true freshmen play, just because of that development process in the summer, you know. And that was nice to where when it's player run, we've got older guys that know our system to where they can go out there and actually still coach. So we can do it in a meeting room, but we can't go on the field with them. And then now our older guys on the field, they're bringing them through pre-practice and Indy and 7-on, and they're doing all that stuff. And then now you look up and you're in August, well, shit, they've been doing this for 2 months. You know, so now they feel pretty good about your install.
You didn't know anything about Houston yet when you start to look at them, or what can you tell us so far about Houston?
Obviously, yeah, I mean, I think they're really talented on the perimeter outside at receiver. You know, the top two receivers are back. The leading rusher's back. Good player. It was a transfer from Texas. You know, obviously the quarterback position, you know, with the transfer having set out last year. Postuma played good ball when he came in last year, the two games he came in. And then they got the athlete that's a receiver hybrid, you know, that I think threw the ball 15 times in their last scrimmage. That they'll have some things for. And then they signed a talented freshman in Bryson Smith. You know, so obviously they're worried about the quarterback position. But again, you know, they do a good job developing quarterbacks. And you know, obviously with Major and Brian there now, you know, they're quarterback guys. So they're talented outside. Their starting tailback is back. I think he's a good player. Up front, I think they're still filling some holes. But you look at their bowl game, all five of those guys that started in the bowl game are back. So they're talking about all the O-lines depleted and all that. Well, the last game you played, all five are back. So you can't be that damn worried about it. All right. So I think they're good up front. You know, don't get it twisted. So we'll have our work cut out for us. That's, you know, ain't no doubt about it.
Who do you think is going to take their first snap at quarterback?
Well, I would think, you know, just the publicity of Kyle, how you don't start him. So we'll see how that works out. They got to worry about that.
I think you might be right.
So.